She is one of the most recognizable voices in Canadian music. Jann Arden has sold millions of albums all around the world in a career that has spanned almost two decades. And now she is back with her 10th studio album. It's called Free. And the great Jann Arden joining us this morning.
I had the same outfit on then as I do right now sitting here. That's how very little has changed.
That's good.
Oh, yeah, you can wear a jacket for 40, 50, 60 years. I've enjoyed talking to you.
Bye-bye. I was reading that you said that this, I don't know, I find this kind of odd that you said this album is so deeply personal, and I've always associated your music as being deeply personal.
What do you mean by that?
I don't know. I'm the one answering my own questions.
I think my music is very much about simple sentiment. Yeah. I don't think you're going to hear me at a rave. Hey, well, let's go do some E and listen to Jann Arden at a warehouse.
Boom, boom, boom.
So, exactly. I think it's very much about personal consumption. I'm great for housework and driving in your car on the way to Costco and, you know, I mean, I'm proud of that. I think a personal relationship with a song is much more valid to me than being a background music, you know, filled with a room with cigarette smoke and drunk people. And so I'm very proud of my little niche.
People feel very strongly about your music. And my good mother, when I hear that, I mean, boy, you know, I got to be careful what company I'm keeping when that's playing. I mean, it evokes strong emotions in people.
Well, I'm glad about that. I've probably received more feedback, you know, via email or snail mail from good mother than anything I've ever done. So
You and technology is something you embraced, you know, early on. You're tweeting, you're blogging. I mean, you really get it.
I mean, I love my tweet. Ooh, that didn't sound very nice.
But you don't have a tweet surrogate. You don't have people who are doing it. You do this.
Yeah, I enjoy it. You know, it's challenging. 140 characters. You have to get in there and be a little humorous. Or I'm not real political on there, but I do enjoy the social medium.
Yes. Well, you were blogging, quite often. And so tell me about Free. Tell me about. I mean, you said that in your blog, actually, that.
Stop reading my blogs. Make up your own interview questions.
But you said in it, it's called research.
No,
why would I go through
not.
Anybody else?
It's
I want to hear from
I don't
you.
Want to get up any earlier than I already have to. No, I've been writing journals. I mean, I don't call them blogs to this day, but I've been doing it since I was a kid. I have a metal box of my grandfather's that's filled with those little 99-cent diaries that had the little key. And, you know, whenever I've had too much to drink, I'll often go in and reminisce of what I was doing when I was 12 and a half. You know, and everything's in code, and I have no idea what the hell I was talking about now, you know, some 14, 15 years later. Okay, 39. But, you know, I'll say, went over with JR, and we did a LD at the IUD of the DUI. I have no idea. But, yeah, it's a really great way to sharpen your writing skills, I think, is just the exercise of writing.
You're going to perform the next half hour?
I am. I've been yodeling since about 4 a.m. just to, you know, I've got a few high notes that I'm not even looking forward to.
Okay.
But stay tuned because...
For the yodeling.
Well, even if people want to see me crash on live television, oh, she didn't hit that note, did she, honey?
Thank you, Jen.
Thank you, Seamus.
Coming up on AM in 15 minutes, bringing a little country to Canada, miles away from her new album, Free, and right after that, she'll perform the title track.
I can picture you asleep in your bed. A massive explosion of thoughts in your head. Life seems complicated when you fall in love and out again. You fall in love and out again.
thoughts running round in your brain. Time seems confiscated when you fall in love and out again. Complicated when